Hello guys and gals, it's me, Mojo Daddy Mystic, and I'm back with another groovy reaction. And on this one, we are taking a look at the one and only Paul Simon with his song, American Tune. Now, I don't really know which album this comes off of, or if this was just a single, but I'm going to guess Still Crazy after all these years, around that period, around 74, 75. Coincidentally, we are going to take a look at a live version of this song off of the Dick Cavett Show from 1974. And this was when he was working on songs for Still Crazy after all these years. So it might very well be on that album. So with all that being said, first off, what are your thoughts on Paul Simon as a solo artist? I mean, my gosh, Graceland, it's right up there under African Skies. I did a review with that with Uncle Ted, so go check that out if you haven't already. But yeah, I mean, Paul Simon is really just a musical genius. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. One of the greatest songwriters of the 21st century, or the 20th century. And he's just an overall groovy cat. But what are your thoughts on Paul Simon's solo work? What do you think of, if it is on the album, what do you think of the album Still Crazy after all these years? Let's get into American Tune and see what all the fuss is about. Let's vibe. Plus, I'm a fan of Dick Cavett, too. Troubadour.
Many's the time I've been mistaken, and many times confused. Yes, and I've often felt forsaken and certainly misused. Oh, but I'm all right, I'm all right. I'm just weary to my bones. Still, you don't expect to be bright and bold. So far away from home.
Wow.
So far away from home. And I don't know a soul who's not been battered. I don't have a friend who feels at ease. Dream that's not been shattered or driven to its knees. Oh, but it's all right, it's all right, for we lived so well, so long. Still, when I think of the road we're traveling on, I wonder what's going wrong. I can't help but I wonder what's going wrong. And I dreamed I was dying. I dreamed that my soul rose unexpectedly, and looking back down at me, smiled reassuringly. And I dreamed I was flying, and high up above, my eyes could clearly see the Statue of Liberty sailing away to sea. And I dreamed I was flying. Oh, we come on the ship they call the Mayflower. Or come on the ship that sailed the moon. We come in the ages most uncertain hours and sing an American tune. Oh, but it's alright. It's alright, it's alright. You can't be forever blessed. Tomorrow's gonna be another working day, and I'm trying to get some rest. That's all I'm trying, to get some rest.
That's all we're trying to do. Oh my God. Oh man. That made me feel some type of way. That really made me feel some type of way. Makes you want to say hallelujah. Thank God for Paul Simon and his artistry. Wow. Oh my gosh, I'm blown away. So, okay, breakdown. American tune. That was one of the best songs I've ever heard in my life. One of the best performances I've ever seen. Acoustically. In general. So from what I take from that is that he, in this song, he's breaking down different segments of American life. And I need your help on this, guys and gals. What does he mean? What is the meaning of American tune? But I'm going to tell you what I took from this song, what I think the meaning is. So in that song, I'm getting imagery of the Mayflower landing and people docking on Ellis Island, bringing immigrants over to the country. And seeing, I can imagine myself being an immigrant, seeing the Statue of Liberty for the first time, and just seeing, a new world and a new country for the first time, and all thinking about all the possibilities and escaping your life, your previous home life of your home country, and you're terrified because you don't know what to expect, you don't have any money. You don't know anybody, but the reason you got on that boat or that ship or what have you is for opportunity, because you heard that America was the land of opportunity and you could make something for yourself. You could start a new life. You could try for a better life for your family or others. So he was in that section of the song. While he was singing, I was getting images of that. And that same goes for the Mayflower. The founders the Mayflower docked on Plymouth, you know, coming over here. That's the same kind of they had the same sort of mission, sort of goal, hoping for a new life, a new escaping British, you know, the British monarchy, and coming over here to seek, you know, America and, you know, its freedom. But, you know, that's just the mojo way of explaining it. I'm sure you guys have a better version of it. But he did, in that song, it made me, you know, feel like a guy out there on his own. No, you know, not a dime to his name, not a penny to his name, scared out of his mind. But he's in America, so he can change his life just like that with a little bit of hard work and a little bit of luck. It's not going to be easy, but I don't know if I'm even in the right ballpark. Let me know your comments down below. What was I in the right park, in the right area? Let me know. A troubadour in every sense of the word, a true American songwriter, one of the best ever do it, Paul Simon. Thank you, sir, for your brilliance and just your overall coolness, man. Thank you. What are your thoughts on American Tune? Did you like it? Did you not like it? Let me know in the comments below. What do you think the song means? Let me know down below. This is your Hippie with Harmony, Mojo Daddy Mystic. Wishing you peace, love, and happiness. Until next time, stay groovy. Name that feeling.